I'll be presenting the use of a relatively new technique, that is 3D printing, in the surgical repair of complex malformations. In our case, a large pulmonary AV malformation. I bring you greetings from my state, which is situated in the north of India, that is called Punjab. It's a deeply religious and a very active, physically active state. Greetings from my team, the heart team, our staff, that's our intensive care unit, the post-operative ICU. Now, the case was a 23-year-old male who presented with a history of deep cyanosis and clubbing since birth. He had a high hematocrit and a very low saturation on room air and on oxygen. So that's the patient. You can see he's a young man. He's got deep cyanosis and very prolonged chronic standing clubbing. He was investigated and we found on imaging that he had a large lesion, arteriovenous malformation in the right lung, lower lobe of the right lung. As you can see, it's occupying a large part of the lung, and the CT showed the feeding arteries and the draining veins. Now, to get a better idea of how to tackle this lesion, we had a 3D print made of this lesion. This was made in this machine, which is called a U-print machine. It's a relatively new technology, and although it has been used for various cardiac malformations in the surgical treatment of various cardiac malformations. This is the print, 3D print that we got, and we realized that it gave us an excellent view, understanding of the anatomy. You can see over here the draining veins and the feeding arteries and the size of the malformation. So we presented this at grand rounds and had a discussion on how best to tackle this lesion. The first plan was to close it with endovascular technique using an emplatzer device, and here we wanted to be sure of the size of the device and where to put the device on which branch of the pulmonary artery. While we were getting ready with the procurement of the device, the patient had a bout of hemoptysis, and then so we decided to go ahead with surgery. And now, since even during surgery, now because of the 3D print, we had a good understanding of the anatomy and what we would be seeing during the surgery. This 3D print allows you to see through tissues and to see you through blood also. So this patient underwent a double lung intubation after bronchoscopy. A right posterolateral, standard right posterolateral thoracotomy was done, and this showed on collapsing the lung, we could see the right lower lobe, and there was a huge, very angry looking arteriovenous malformation, as you can see over here. Now, from our knowledge of the 3D print and of course the CT scan, we knew exactly where to proceed. So first, the feeding artery was dissected out neatly. We made sure that the artery to the middle lobe, as you can see over here, was not geopardized, and the artery to the lower segment of the upper lobe. So both of them were clearly visualized and dissected. The pulmonary artery feeding the lower lobe was looped and then was divided between clamps and repaired with 6-0 proline. So this is after tying off the pulmonary artery. You can see the lesion still looks quite big. So then we divided the inferior pulmonary ligament. Here we are showing deliberately that inferior pulmonary ligament should not be divided blindly, because very often there is a feeding vessel in this, as you can see over here. So it should always be flushed, the vessel should be seen and clipped, and then it should be divided. Then the inferior pulmonary vein was isolated. You can see it's a very dilated pulmonary vein because there was a huge amount of blood which is going directly into it. So that was the inferior pulmonary vein is clamped, divided, and then repaired with 6-0-proline continuous. During all this procedure, we continued to have a look at the 3D print, which gave us again an idea of exactly what was happening. We could see through the tissues and through the blood because of the print being available to us. Then we came to the bronchus. We isolated the bronchus to the lower lobe, clamped it with a soft clamp and inflated the lung to make sure that no other part, the middle lobe or the any other part of the lung other than the lower lobe was being clamped. Once we were sure of the bronchus to the lower lobe, we stapled it and then divided it. So this is showing the stapler being used. After stapling, the bronchus still divided and the specimen was removed. Showing the division of the bronchus. So that's the specimen. That's the bronchus to the lower lobe. You can see it very clearly. Then, as we routinely do, we checked the bronchial stump for any leak by having the anesthetist hyperinflate the lung to 30 millimeters of mercury pressure. So that's showing the inflating the lung. Checking all the suture lines, that's the pulmonary artery, which has been repaired with 6-0-proline. As you can see, the artery to the middle lobe and to the inferior part of the upper lobe was left intact. That's the artery to the middle lobe. That's the bronchus, which was stapled, and that is the inferior pulmonary vein, which has been repaired, opening directly into the left atrium. So that's the specimen, and we are superimposing the 3D print, showing the exact similarity of the specimen to the 3D print, both in size and to the composition. We were quite impressed with the accuracy of the 3D print. That is the AV malformation which has been opened up, showing where it had opened into the bronchus. Of course, the moment we clamped the pulmonary artery, the saturation came up to 100, as you can see. Patient tolerated the procedure well. These are the comparison of the gas reports, arterial blood gas, before and after. Patient is nice and pink post-operatively, and a happy young man now, doing very well. So what are the advantages of 3D printing? It makes planning of a complex lesion much more precise and accurate. We can have different plans. Like in our patient, we had planned A, which was an endovascular emplatzer device, but since the patient bled and we were not ready with the device, we went to plan B, which had already been planned. So it avoids emergency planning in the OT. Of course, preoperatively, once we show the print to the patient, we can better counsel the patient and the relatives. It is good for training purposes, for teaching the residents, like a batting practice. It allows the surgeon to see around corners and through blood, and you can make a trial run of the procedure. So it reduces operating time, and in case it is a intracardiac lesion, it will reduce your bypass time. There are less chances of residual lesion because you know exactly where and when where the lesion is. There are less chances for reintervention because you've tackled the lesion completely. As I said, it's better for training, gives you a trial run. Sometimes maybe you may be able to assess hemodynamics by putting in a virtual valve, simulating it on the computer, closing a hole on the computer and then seeing what happens to the hemodynamics. So it's a refined approach and a good procedural planning. Thank you. Greetings from my state once again.